tell you, you want me to tell you more stories?
Yeah.
Okay. So this next song, came from a trip that I did up when I was first guided up into Arnhem Land, which is northeast Arnhem Land at the top of Australia. It's that's a Yolngu territory I was talking about. That's where Yidaki comes from. That place in Australia was never settled by the British. So it's still Aboriginal law up there. And it's still a place where our culture is thriving. When I was younger, I was adopted up there by a man who was a very powerful Yidaki player and culture man. He took me up to his country and he wanted to give me the blessing to carry that instrument and to learn about that instrument and its traditional roots. So I went up with him and there was plenty that I learnt, and I was very touched by that country and that trip and those stories, ancient stories. When I was up there, there was one creation story that I learnt about, which was about the honey bag man, and he was one of the creation ancestors that created a mountain range in Arnhem Land there. And back in the 1970s, there was a mining operation that first went into Arnhem Land. So there hadn't been any, although there was a lot of oppression of Aboriginal people around the rest of the country, there hadn't been any industry yet that had moved in on Arnhem Land and started to take that country and wreck that sacred land. And the first mining push was they wanted to take out the side of this mountain, which was part of this dreaming story of the honeybag man. And the local people, for the first time in that area, decided that they weren't going to let that happen. Aboriginal people in Australia got pushed around a lot because they're very peaceful people. They're very trusting, and so they were easily manipulated by the British, and they were easily pushed around. But the Yolngu people at that point decided, okay, we're not going to listen to this. And the men painted up with spears. They went up with spears on the side of that mountain, and they stood in front of the bulldozers and they said, nah, you're not coming any further. So there was this photo that got printed in the paper back in the early 70s, and it was, I think the headline said, savages stand up for their land. So it was still in those days, you know, they were still referring to Aboriginal people as savages, and that was kind of the mentality. And it's this amazing photo. There's a bulldozer, and right in front of it was all these warriors, and they're standing in front of front of that bulldozer, and they actually saved that mountain. And after that, they sent a bark petition, so a piece of bark with signatures was sent down to Parliament in Canberra, and that was all part of the government protecting that piece of land in Arnhem Land. And that was actually the first land rights case in Australia. And then the land rights movement sort of gathered momentum from there. But being up on that country and learning about that story traditionally, and then seeing, you know, the aftermath and you know, that situation, and being told that story from the creation right through to the standoff, really hit me hard. And I remember when I left that particular trip, I was on the way home from Gove. I was on a plane and I wrote this song out on the Qantas boarding pass. I remember, I think I've still got it, but on the boarding pass I wrote all this, and I'm going to play you this song. It's called Land Rights Song. Thank you.
stood on the mountain for their land rights, and northern people noticed movement took flight. They said, this is our home, these are our rights. Ooh, this is our home, these are our rights. Now free to be passed. Cup that was empty, slowly filling up. We can pull together, show our children it is time. 'Cause this is our home, these are. This is out.